Thank you very much. Thank you very much. To all of Brockton citizens who are here today to commemorate Memorial Day 2015, I thank you. Today's a special day in our nation's history. We recall the sacrifices made by all veterans, particularly those who have given their life in the service of their country. This time, I would ask a member of the Brockton Fire Department to step forward and give us the command a presentation of colors.
Details!
Details.
Carry colors!
At this time, the Brockton High School marching band will play the national anthem. Please remove any covers if you're not in uniform. This time, I'd like to invite George Cataldo, a veteran of World War II, to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
All right, you guys know the Pledge of Allegiance?
Yes.
All right. Scout salute.
You ready? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you.
All right, boys, back over here, please.
At this time, I'd like to invite Fire Department Chaplain Reverend Carlos Suarez for the invocation.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, on this Memorial Day, we pray for those who courageously laid down their lives for the cause of freedom and to protect the well-being of all people of goodwill. May their example of sacrifice inspire us to live this selfless love in imitation of your Son, who reminds us that there is no greater love than to lay down one's life for one's friends. Bless the families of our fallen troops, and fill their homes and lives with your strength and peace. In union with people of goodwill everywhere, embolden us to answer the call to work for peace and justice, and thus to seek an end to violence and conflict everywhere. And this we ask in your most holy name. Amen.
Thank you, Father. This time, I think it's important to recall the words of our former president, Ronald Reagan. As we honor their memory today, let us pledge that their lives, their sacrifices, their valor shall be justified and remembered for as long as God gives life to this nation. I'd like to introduce the mayor of the City of Champions, Bill Carpenter.
Well, thank you, Dave. Thank you so much, everyone that's here with us for this occasion this morning. I know that most people refer today as the unofficial first day of summer, and it's great to see so many of you turning out to help us remember and recognize the true meaning of Memorial Day and recognizing those who did not make it home. I do want to recognize a number of folks here with us today. We have a number of elected officials with us from the legislature. We have State Representatives Claire Cronin is here, Michelle Dubois, and Mike Brady. We have a number of city councilors here. City councilors at large Jay Stewart, Bob Sullivan, and Moises Rodriguez are all here, along with city councilors Dennis DiNapoli, Shirley Asak, and Paul Studensky. From the Brockton School Committee, we have Ray Henningsen and Judy Sullivan in attendance. From the Southeastern Regional School Committee, Mark Lindy is here. Plymouth County Registrar of Deeds, John Buckley, is with us here this morning. And I think I got all the elected officials. If I miss someone, I'm sure it'll be pointed out to me right away. I do also want to mention a couple of folks who are unable to join us this morning. First of all, World War II veteran William Hakim, who recently celebrated his 100th birthday, sends his regrets but was unable to join us. And also, a fixture here at every single veterans event, Benito Fiore, quite unfortunately lost his wife yesterday and is unable to be here, but we ask that everyone take a moment to remember Benito this morning and his family. We're here celebrating Memorial Day to remember those fallen heroes, those who were willing to pay the ultimate price to protect all the things that we cherish here in the United States of America, our freedom, our values, and all those things that we take for granted. And on a day like today, we must remember that others paid an enormous price so that we could enjoy the liberty that we enjoy today. I think today is about remembering, and it's also about honoring, and honoring the memory of those that fell. And I think perhaps the best way we can honor their memory is by taking care of the veterans that are coming home, that have returned and that are still returning home, and making sure that our vets have the best treatment in the world, have all the services that they need, have our support, that we support the families of those who are serving away from home, and that we make sure that we heal all the injuries both inside and outside of those returning. And let us all make a commitment today that we should never ever use the words homeless and veteran in the same sentence. So I thank you so much for being here to join us in these ceremonies. God bless the USA.
Thank you, Your Honor. As we are accustomed to do, we honor two particular veterans who passed away in the last 12 months, who were behind the scenes volunteers who did a lot for Brockton veterans without any sort of recognition. One of them was Anthony Zarella, a retired Brockton police officer. He dedicated to the principle of serving and protecting, and he carried that into retirement. He served in the United States Marine Corps during the Korean War. He was available to help veterans or perform some service to assist a veteran service officer all the time. A few years ago, without fanfare, he and another veteran washed all of the veteran stones at Melrose Cemetery. There were over 1,000 of them. He served as commander of the 1st Lieutenant Brian McPhillips Marine Corps Detachment 1115, based in Easton. You may have noticed several members of that detachment marched with us today. He loved the company of other people and was a fixture at the Italian Kitchen on Saturday mornings. He was accomplished a small engine repair and tinkerer, always willing to help with a project or volunteer his time. Another veteran who passed away most recently, Joe DeMarco. Joe was one of 14 children. He lived on Elliott Street. He was a veteran of the Korean War, served in the United States Navy. He was a retired member of the United States Air Force and also served in the United States Marine Corps. He was retired as a mechanic from Polaroid Corporation and after 24 years worked at the Reiser Corporation in Canton. He was a lifetime member and past commander of the VFW Post 697 of Whitman. He was a life member of the Italian-American War Veterans and a longtime chaplain of that unit, and they're based out of the War Memorial Building on West Elm Street, which is open Monday through Friday, 8:30 to 4:30, all veterans and any citizens of this great community are welcome to come in and view the building. It's really beautiful, and you take time out of your day sometime, come by and see us. Thank you very much. Now, at this time, we commemorate those Brockton veterans, those Brockton service members who gave their life in the service of their country. One of them is Michael Carteret. His mother, Elsie, just turned 90 a few weeks ago. Please give her a hand for her longevity and her dedication to this annual event. Accompanying me today will be two other family members of a lost soldier of the Operation Iraqi Freedom, Enduring Freedom. He gave his life, Sergeant Alberto Montron, on February 13th, 2006, in Afghanistan. We will never forget his sacrifice, and today we're honored to have his sister, Carmen, and her sister here as well to help bring our memorial wreath to the Veterans of All Wars Monument. So if you at this time, Carmen, would you help me?
Thank you.
Parade, rip!